Elliot. I run Popstalgia. This year is the fifth year at Bosworth Water Trust, Nuneaton in Warwickshire. We started doing it 5 years ago due to the love of pops, my dad having a Fulton and me being a bit of a pop perv, starting a Facebook page up and decided to do a show. So 5 years later, it's getting busier, different cars each year, and that's it. Yeah, pops are making a comeback. And it's a good thing, really, because we got shunned during the 90s a bit and the early noughties because of all the new metal Model A's, cams and all that. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They are coming round again, aren't they?
They're coming round again. People are spending money on them. There's some big names building pops, you know. There's guys from back in the day like John Baldacchino building Saint again, like another Fulton. And you've got all the old names coming back and they're getting appreciated more.
More valuable.
No, yeah. So, yeah, it's good. They deserve it. You know, they do deserve it. I think the pop is the English rod. The Americans have got the 34s or 32s and that. Unfortunately, for English version, they're money. But I don't think a pop or a Fulton or a Prefect is anything better looking. Really. I love them.
Hi, my name's Steve. Own the Ford 300E van. Little roof chop, used to be called Orange Squashed. Built back in 92 by a chap called Dave Harvey. I owned it 10 years ago and had a mad rush of blood to the head Christmas and decided to try and track it down. Refound it back in February. Bought it and it's a work in progress. Rebuilt the engine. It's going next year for the acid dip. And total rebuild, new paint. Got to respray a nice dark black. That's all we got to say, really.
I'm with Anthony Ward. You've had this pop 15 years, you've just been telling me.
15 years.
Was it show standard at that point?
It was show standard at that point with a 3-litre V6 in it.
I mean, obviously, I'm looking at it's got a V8 now, so did you put that in?
Yes, I did, yeah.
Did you rebuild it or did you just buy it as a crate?
No, I rebuilt it. It's a 302 Ford. I built it to a book of 300 brake. It's on a C4 gearbox, auto. Half of the front suspension's the same. It had a HA Viva on the front, but then I've narrowed it and put airbags in there.
So I've got to say the colour gold is an unusual choice, isn't it? How did that come about? Were you just fed up with reds and blacks and the blues?
I was a Peugeot mechanic for years, and that's the colour is an old Peugeot 306 106 blaze yellow. I've used a different base coat and the paint's probably a little bit thicker than the original car, so it's a slightly different shade, but everyone at the time told me the colour wouldn't work.
No, it really does suit the car, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And was it professionally done or did you paint it yourself?
It was myself.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Well, it stood the time, it's 15 years ago now it's been in colour, so it's not done too bad.